weekend, Briggs and Al run?
Right now, we're here in the morning, you know, just going around for hours run, you know, taking care of the kids, and it's a beautiful day. And, you know, we're just having a good time with the kids. They're having a good time with us, and, you know, we're just happy to be here.
Hey, do you still have your Buzz's Bunch bracelet from camp? Yeah. Do you remember? Do you need another one?
No.
Okay, all right.
Buzz's Bunch is kids with disabilities. They come here for camp for free, and they interact with us. We meet them, take pictures, do whatever they want.
Ready? One, two, three. All right.
And we greet the families. We usually build a relationship or a connection with them.
That's good. You signed the back of your shirt.
Thank you.
It's not just, oh, they're here running. We actually want to get to know them and know their story.
What's your name?
Connor.
I'm Ben. Nice to meet you, Connor.
Coach knows them all by their first names. He talks to them like they're his own kids.
What's up, Riley? How you been?
Good.
Been doing all right? You look good.
It's just a joy, you know, to help the kids and, you know, help the disabled kids and their families, you know, what they're going through.
Oh! Put it in there.
You know, there's guys on this team that have been through adversity and been through tough times too. So, you know, here to help kids at the Owl Run and see the parents smiling and the parents loving us being there is just, it's just something extra for us to do. And, you know, we just love doing that kind of stuff.
Above the rim, baby.
This year at Owl's Run, I could see that everybody was involved and engaged. It was like we were being kids, but I don't think that everybody understands that, you know, we're very privileged for what we have, and they live a way, way harder life than we do. We're in fairy tale land, which is what Buzz calls it nowadays.
Jimmy Butler.
They're out there in the real world, and they're dealing with the biggest obstacles that you could ever think of. So we got the utmost respect for them, and you know, this is the least that we can do is go out and show support for them. But it's fun because it's not about basketball. Everything's not about basketball. It's about life sometimes.
3, 2, 1. A lot of people look up to this organization. So for us to actually have the chance to get out there and give back to kids that's not as fortunate as us, I feel like I didn't do enough just by smiling. I feel like there's still more that I can do.
Have a good season.
It's a lot of fun out there. We all were engaged. And a lot of people look up to us. And I don't want people to think, oh, those Marquette guys are arrogant. They don't care about anybody but themselves.
Marquette basketball team right here.
I think our relationship with the fans is, you know, they do a great job in supporting us, you know, especially guys that are not All-Americans, guys who aren't top in the class or whatnot. And they respect that at times, you know. Not being, you know, the best player out of high school, myself, the fans didn't really know who I was as a basketball player. But once I start to show them who I was as a person, they start respecting who I was as a basketball player.
They take time out of their day to come watch us play. What if we're not the best team in the nation, but they still like us, you know? You gotta think 16,000, those amount of fans come to our games. So why not be able to shake 16,000 hands for probably the 16,000 people that come out and support us.
I've never told our guys how long they should stay for anything. I think that speaks to the character of our guys. That's who they are.
We stay to the end because we gotta finish out everything. Basketball, Owls Run, Marquette Madness, you know. You always gotta fight to the end. And just like the Owls Run, kids and parents, they're gonna give it all they got every day until the very end. So why should we be any different? You know, they support us to the very end. They'll be there until that clock hits 0.00 in the second half. So we're gonna support them to the very end. And we're gonna always be there for them, the Buzz's Bunch people, everybody, until the very end, because that's just who we are as people, who we are as players, and that's just what we're taught.
I admire them for that. I stand at attention for the example that they set. And again, that's not because I'm telling them. It's not because you guys are here filming. That's just who they are. And that's what's so pure about all of it, is that's who they are. And that's why you do see the joy. And that's why the picture is worth 1,000 words. I don't have to say it. Our kids don't have to say it. Just look at the picture. That's what it is. And that's good living. That's beautiful. It's beautiful.